Hi guys, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. For today's video, we are here with a new exciting interview question videos. So without making this intro any longer, let's get into the video. 1. What is the minimum pipe size required for the thermowell installation and why? Ideally 3 inches minimum, but practically 4 inches. Because thermowells are sold by insertion lengths, which is the length of the thermowell inside the pipe. The right length for a thermowell largely depends on the diameter of the pipe or tube. One rule of thumb is to insert a thermowell anywhere from 1/3 to 2/3 of the way into the fluid stream. Other guidelines recommend that the insertion length can be 10 times the thermowell tip diameter or a minimum of 2 inches, that is 50 mm into the process. On the one hand, the longer the insertion length, the greater the chances that the thermowell will bend or suffer mechanical fatigue due to the process media's velocity. On the other hand, the shorter the insertion length, the greater the chances that users will see unreliable results due to poorer heat transfer. In summary, there is no one perfect stem length for a thermowell, but the goal is to balance the outcome. Next. What are design considerations for the pipe rack? Rack width, number of levels and elevations, bend spacing to decide the clearance between two tiers, pipe flexibility to plan thermal expansion loops, access and maintenance of each item in pipe rack if any, road crossings, also consideration for electrical and instrument cable tray, future requirement and contingency if planning is at early stage. Next, what are the steps involved in rack design? First, generate the line routing diagram to find the line origin and destination with minimum travel length based on the process flow diagram and preliminary PNID. Calculate bend spacing between tier to tier, set rack width and decide elevations and levels. Next. What factors affect the pipe span? Factors affecting pipe span are size, schedule, that is thickness of pipe, liquid or vapor, insulated or bare pipe. Next, how do you decide which lines to be placed where in rack? Process lines on lower level, utility lines on top level, instrument and electrical cable trays on utility level or separate topmost level, heavy lines near column, flare lines outside the rack on cantilever beams or inside rack above top level, steam lines or hot lines with expansion loop on one side of rack, lines with orifice runs on one side of rack besides column for maintenance using portable ladder. If we have cool lines and hot lines running on same rack, we have to plan the loop location separately as hot lines will have expansion and cold lines undergo contraction. Next, how much extra space is required for rack? Usually 20% of extra space is required for future lines on each tier, but it all depends on the client approval and requirement. Next, what is double block and bleed and where it is used? Two block walls with bleed ring in between with a bleed valve connected to the hole of bleed ring to provide complete isolation. Mostly it is used to prevent product contamination or where it is necessary to remove essential equipment from service for cleaning or repairs while the unit continues in operation. Next, what is a bleed valve? Small valve provided for drawing of liquid. In layman terms, we call it drain valve. Next, what is relief valve? Valve to relieve excess pressure in liquids in situations where full flow discharge is not required, where release of small volume of liquid would rapidly lower pressure. Next, what is safety valve? Rapid opening, popping action, full flow valve for air and other gases. Relief valve is used in liquids, whereas safety valves are used in gases and vapors. Next, how to close a gate valve? Turn the hand wheel in clockwise direction. Next, in which position lever-operated valves open and close? If the lever is parallel to the pipe, it is in open condition, and if it is perpendicular to the pipe, it is in closed condition. Next, how to calculate space between pipe to pipe? For staggered case, the space calculation is half of pipe OD of flange of bigger pipe plus half of OD of smaller pipe plus insulation plus clearance, that is 25 to 50 mm from edge of pipe or flange or insulation. Let's see an example here. If these pipes are 6 inches and 12 inches respectively and pressure rating is 150 and bottom pipe is 6 inches having insulation of 40 mm, then the distance between 6 inch and 12 inch bare pipe is equal to half of pipe OD of flange of 12 inch pipe, that is 241.5 mm plus half of OD of smaller pipe, that is a 6 inches pipe, which is 84 mm plus insulation as it is 0 in this case and clearance that will be considered as 25 mm. So distance would be 350.5 mm. Similarly, distance between 6 inch insulated pipe and 12 inch bare pipe would be more than the insulation of 6 inch pipe, that is 40 mm. The clearance would be 390.5 mm. Please remember, flange dimensions are different for 150 pound rating, 300 pound rating, 600 pound rating, and so on. If stress requires additional space for thermal movement, we need to provide this space and as an addition. Next, how much clearance we kept from steel to pipe? It should be 75 mm minimum from outer edge of pipe or insulation. Next, how to remove strainer from T-type strainer? Strainer is to be removed from top, so strainer shall be free from any obstructions. Next, what are the considerations we have to take for temporary strainer or conical strainer? Strainer should be easily removed by adding a pipe support or pipe stand close to the strainer and or a removable spool with little higher length of strainer so that the strainer can be removed easily. It should be possible to remove the temporary strainer without shutting down the process with the help of a redundant piece of equipment that can be used while the strainer is being removed or with block walls to allow bypass the strainer. Next, how much clearance we kept from floor or grade to any drain valve? It should be 75 mm minimum from grade to bottommost edge of valve for collection tray. So that is it guys for today's video. We love reading your comment and suggestions, so please comment below. We do read every single one of your comment. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share with your friends and colleagues who may find it useful. If you have any time, please check out our other videos over there.